Welcome to this session on test execution reports in Katalon Studio. In Katalon Studio, we have reports generated after test case execution, test suite execution, and test suite collection execution. Today, we are going to look into these three reports, and we will also look at some useful tips. Let's get started, and let us look at our test case reports. Let us go to our Katalon Studio, and we have this test case 1 that we have recorded in our earlier session for Orange HRM website. I have executed this test case, so I'm not going to re-execute it. To save time, let us directly go to this log viewer. So once you will execute your test case, you will get this log viewer and you can double click it so that it becomes maximized. And here you can see the very first row gives you the run information, the pass, fails and error count. And then in this section, you can see the filters. So you can filter these logs based on all these criteria, pass, failed, error, and so on. And you can go to any of the step. For example, I want to know why did this step failed. I can double click it and it will give me the root cause of the failure. So this is going to be very useful to troubleshoot your execution. And if you go to the top, here you have this tree view. If you click here, you will get your logs generated in a tree view. So the same logs that we were looking in the standard view are now in the tree view. And again, here you can go to any step, you can maximize, and it will also give you the messages. For example, this test case failed because of this error, and also it gives you this particular line number. If you go here, click here, it will take you to that particular line where the failure happened. So this is going to be very efficient and useful while you are troubleshooting your runs. So this is about the test case report, and some of the major features are you have these execution filters, you have the tree view, and you have the scroll lock. Let us look at the scroll lock here. This is the icon for scroll lock, and the functionality of scroll lock is while your test case is running, you can look into the log viewer. The logs are also generated dynamically. So the latest logs are generated at the bottom and the earlier logs keep going up. In case you want to freeze the logs, you can click this scroll lock so that the logs will get freezed and then you can troubleshoot. So we have the scroll lock, and also the test case report is not preserved. So this is not a historical report. These logs will be preserved for the session of Katalon Studio. Once you close your Katalon Studio, you will not get back these logs. So this was about test case report. Let us go and look into test suite report. Again, I'm going to my Katalon Studio, and we have these test suites created earlier. I have created test suite 3 where we have these two test cases, and I have already run it. And I am going to the reports section. Inside this, I have test suite 3 and this report. So the name is the year, month, date, and the time. Let us double click here, and this is the report. You get this overview of the test suite, how many test cases are there, what is the status of execution. Again, we get these filters, so you can filter out the pass, failed, and other options. So this will be very useful when you have lots of test cases in your test suite and you want to filter out just the failed ones or the passed ones. And then if you go down, you have this summary section. So here in the summary, you can see the summary of this test suite, how many total test cases were ran, pass, failed, and other options. Then we have this execution settings. So again, you have this some useful information here, and then we have the execution environment. So here, this will be very useful if you want to know the Selenium version, the Katalon Studio version, the browser, or the operating system on which your test suite ran. And then we have this option for show test case details. Let me just maximize this window and go to this show test case details. And now if I'll click on any of the test case here, its corresponding details will be fetched here. So let me click on test 1, and you can see all the details of test 1 execution are being displayed here. Again, we have a very handy filter here, so I can filter out all these options. And if you click on any of the step, you can see at the below section, the details are getting generated. Okay, so this is again going to be very useful, and you can also expand and look at the steps. We have the information section, which gives us the execution information of this test case, and the integration section, which is for integration with test management tools, which we will look into it later. So we get all these features in test suite report. One other thing is you can go to the test suite report here, and if you right click it and you go to the open containing folder, it will take you to the folder where the report has been physically written in our disk, and here you can get a CSV file of your report. So this is the CSV file. You also get these logs and execution properties, and then you have this report.html file. If you will click this, you will get the HTML file of your report, and here you can go and look at the details. So it has all those details that we have seen earlier. And let me go to the test step that failed, and here you are getting the actual root cause of the failure, and then you get the screenshot as well. So it will help you a lot in troubleshooting your execution. So let us look at the major features of test suite report. So this is created after test suite execution. It is named with timestamp. It provides all the summary plus details, and we also get a HTML report. And test suite report is preserved, and therefore it's a historical report. It is written to your disk. So even if you exit your Katalon Studio, this report will be preserved. Let us now look at test suite collection report. Again, I'm going to my Katalon Studio, and this is our test suite collection, which has these three test suites, and we have ran the first two. And if again you go to the report section, we have our test suite collection report generated here. Let me bring this up, and you can see this is the report, and here you get the overview of all the test suites that got executed, the environment on which they got executed, the status, and the count of test cases that failed. And then you have this show details link. If you click here, it will again take you to the test suite report that we just saw. So this one was the overview of test suite collection, and then we get the test suite report as we have seen earlier. So this is the test suite report. Again, if you go here, right click, you can go to open containing folder and look at the HTML as well. So the major features of this report are the same as we have test suite reports. It has a timestamp name, it provides summary details, and it has HTML. And again, this is a historical report and it is preserved. Let us look at some useful tips. So we can rename our reports to some meaningful names. You can go to your Katalon Studio and you can right click and rename the report. So you can say this is test suite collection report, and then maybe you can give some date here, which will be more meaningful, or you can give your application module. So you can rename your reports. You can also view the captured screenshot in the reports. So let us go to any of our test suite reports, and if you go here, you can see this icon. This if you go down, wherever you take the screenshot, you can see this icon. If you click here, it will give you the screenshot that you captured. And then you can also open reports after execution. So you can go to your Katalon Studio, go to preferences, and here go to execution, and here you can see open report. So if you check this, the report will open after execution. If you keep it unchecked, the report will not open. You will have to open the report manually after your test case or test suite have been executed. Let us do a very quick recap. Today in this session, we learned about various types of reports that are generated in Katalon Studio. In the next session, we will look into how can we send results in email.